Tonight, a story about people helping people. Some African-American entrepreneurs in North Minneapolis will finally get a space of their very own.
And they owe it all to a Minnesota woman and her labor of love. Devon Rumming explains.
At the intersection of 42nd Avenue North and Lindale sits the old Camden Park State Bank building.
It's not really a beautiful, you know, thing to look at. When you go into the building, it doesn't seem like it's been very well taken care of.
It's been a staple on the north side for more than a century. It's always been a mixed-use space, at one point housing a post office, a mortuary, and various retail outlets. But over time, a portion of the building has sat vacant, with the exception of a few newer businesses.
It has all this historic richness, right? And it could definitely be an asset, but it's not being utilized as that now.
There's potential here, which local entrepreneur Anissa Keys sees, which is why she recently purchased the building for $1 million with the hopes of turning it into a brick and mortar for 15 black-owned business owners.
The space is going to be accessible. It's going to be nice. It's going to be renovated. The rents are going to be affordable. There'll be a law firm, R. Sullivan Law, will be there. You're able to come and eat at a plant-based restaurant. Heal Minneapolis will be in the building. When you come into this building, you'll know that you're supporting a black business, which is, to me, just gives me butterflies.
For Keys, it's an investment in rewriting the script at this intersection, which has seen its fair share of violent crimes.
Oftentimes what gets promoted or what gets put on the screen, right, is all the negative things that are happening. The need is to change the narrative, right? That what they think that they're seeing, right, is not all that's here.
Giving business owners of color and the neighborhood an opportunity to live up to its greatest potential once again.
So hopefully the small businesses are there will use this as a platform, right? That they will just use this as a catalyst, that they won't stay there, that they'll grow.
Devon Rahming, Care 11 News.
Keys and her partners plan to invest $500,000 in renovations of the building. Construction is set to begin in March with a grand opening scheduled for July 1st.